very much, Chairperson. My teacher of us is thank you very much. Now we are going to call on some of our esteemed visitors who came to grace this occasion, all the way from Zimbabwe. The first person that I'm going to call is a person who will be representing the family. His name is Patrick Zuwao, and he's a former Minister of Indigenization in Zimbabwe. He has been persecuted, and he will explain his relationship, but he is the nephew of our late hero, Comrade R.G. Mugabe. Comrade Patrick.
Accept ask Comrade Kasukwere and some of us to start organizing presidential youth interfaces, during which President Mugabe would explain to the people of Zimbabwe that him and his generation were in the sunset of their lives, and that the next liberation would be waged by young people. And because President Mugabe stood for young people, some of his colleagues who he fought for, who he fought with, would not be able to recognize that young people are the future of Africa, that young people will liberate Africa economically. They chose to take arms against President Mugabe, because President Mugabe was committed to pass the torch on to young people so that young people can liberate Africa economically. When President Mugabe was deposed, some of the comrades that are now wanting to stand and pontificate over his funeral refused to acknowledge him. They tormented him. They made him suffer. And the family decided that we could not continue to allow him to watch the news every day in Harare, as the likes of Obabu Chiguri, Mebo Chinomona, Matema Nanda called President Mugabe a traitor. Why do they want to pontificate over him? You did not want him in Zambia. He is wanted here in the DNA. President Mugabe went to Singapore, and he was staying in a rented house in Singapore. He was not in hospital. However, 5 days before he passed on Sunday, his condition deteriorated. When his condition deteriorated, he was taken to hospital. President Mugabe was in hospital for 5 days before he passed on. President Mugabe effectively was tormented by ZANU-PF. He was tormented by the regime of Emmerson Mnangagwa. President Mugabe said, and I quote, "Zimbabwe is where I was born. Zimbabwe is where I will die. And Zimbabwe is where he will be buried." That's what he said. But President Mugabe did not die in Zimbabwe because of Emmerson Mnangagwa. When President Mugabe spoke with members of the family, members of his immediate family, his wife, his children, he gave them specific instructions on what must happen at his funeral and at his burial. I spoke this morning with Amai Mugabe. She instructed me to issue a statement, to disseminate a statement that she and the immediate family had put together. The statement is that they are being coerced by Emmerson Mnangagwa to ignore President Mugabe's wishes on where his mortal remains should be interred. I call upon you, Commander-in-Chief. I call upon you to help the family recognize, help the wishes of President Mugabe be recognized. President Mugabe, it demands of us that we make sure that President Mugabe is able to rest in peace. President Mugabe is able to rest in power. It is not possible that Emmerson Mnangagwa and his henchmen can pontificate over President Mugabe. I thank you.